When I hear chaos engineering, it sounds, just because of the name, like do a bunch of random stuff and see what happens. Is it really that chaotic, or is it more like an organized set of events? Could you walk us through, like, tactically, what does it mean?
Yeah, absolutely. And I think that's a fantastic question, Dan. Like, I think the name chaos engineering is actually a little bit of a misnomer. Like, it's actually as far from chaotic as you can get. It's very controlled, very well thought through. You have to, I mean, the way you think about it is there's a hypothesis that I am trying to figure out here, either yes or no, an assumption that I am trying to validate or disprove. And so the process, at least the way that we educate our customers, is like, no, don't just throw random stuff. You can get there. Like, eventually you want to get to the point where you are automating all of this. We call it continuous chaos because that's nice and buzzy and fits at the end of CI/CD.
All these sayings sound cool. Chaos engineering, continuous chaos. That sounds cool.
I know, right? And originally, back when it was just me and my co-founder writing the code, I called myself the chief chaos engineer, which is just, one of the best. But the idea is that you ultimately want to be able to handle any of this random chaos being thrown at you, because that's what the world is. It's entropy, it's degradation, it's consistently, throwing different things, different chaos at you. But in order to get comfortable with that, in order to build up that muscle, you need to start off very tactical. You need to be very targeted in what you're doing. We really advocate for what we call the set of hosts or the set of containers that you're impacting. We call it the blast radius. And so you want to start the blast radius very, very small. And as you gain confidence, you grow bigger and bigger and bigger. And then eventually, once you're comfortable with that, you're able to run that experiment in a programmatic way, say, at least through the Gremlin product, Monday, Wednesday, Friday during business hours, run this experiment some random time in that window and make sure that our service auto heals or remediates or whatever it is, right?